First and foremost, before we get started, I'd like to give all praise and honor and glory to Yahweh Ba'ashem, Yahweh Shai Ba'ashem, Rekah Kadosh, and double honors to those great millstone, while learned his truth. And also to the Ophelat that is scattered abroad. I'd like to say Shalom and come back here today with another great powerful lesson through the spirit and power of Yahweh Ba'ashem, Yahweh Shai. So the title of the lesson is Chaos by Design. So I'd like to say Shalom to all I listen along. Hope this will help you today and guide you back in the path of righteousness and back to your true power, which in fact is Yahweh Ba'ashem, Yahweh Shai. So before we start today's lesson, I have a quick news article here by NTD. And it says, agents put on high alert after IEDs or an improvised explosive device found near U.S.-Mexican border reports. Let's get a little bit more. It says U.S. Customs and Border Protection, CBP, has warned agents in a internal security memo to be on high alert after the Mexican military seized nearly a dozen improvised explosive device, IEDs, near the border, according to reports. Mexican authorities found the IEDs after a Tucson Border Patrol agent reported gunshot near the border, leading to the arrest of an individual on the U.S. side of the border armed with a AK-47, according to Fox News. Law enforcement sources also provide the outlet with a internal officer safety alert bearing the date, December the 13th, 2023, which reportedly warned Border Patrol agents to exercise extreme caution and report any possible armed subjects approaching the border with possible explosive devices. So we already know that, hey, man, these things are, you know, are constantly what? Increasing. And also that improvised explosive device also, you know, give you an example like a suitcase nuclear bomb, you know, something that is compact. You know, it's different from a conventional explosive device, you know. And, you know, it's more small and more concealed, you know, whereby they can slip it in and also it cause all type of havoc, you know, like, you know, what happened, 9/11, you know, those buildings went down, you know, all sorts of chaos, all sorts of things they get ready to bring, extreme confusion, extreme disorder. So we already know that every day you're hearing something that's going on the southern border, or also you hear rumors that's going on our Canadian and the U.S. side. So we seeing that these things are constantly picking up on what? On every side. So we seeing that, hey, man, they constantly, you know what I'm saying, on high alert. But one thing about it, that we already know that these things is what? It's been designed, been manufactured, you know what I'm saying, what, through the left-hand side, but through the what? Spirit and power of Yahweh Ba'ashem Yahweh Shai. So these things gonna constantly what? Increase every day. You constantly seeing these events. We constantly seeing all these different types of scenarios that's going down each and every, these movies are coming out. So much info is out there, you know. So a lot of people are constantly still are not believing, still are relaxing in their leaves, and these evils are constantly growing all around us. In the middle of the Lord, we're constantly sighing and crying left and right, constantly warning you of these impending dangers. So at any given time, you know, they is already what have warned America that what terror or threats or terrorists threats are coming to American soil. Also, it was a report, also, I think it was yesterday in Europe, that it was terrorist sleeper cells there. You know, it's things of what's happening over there. So we seeing all these things happen, what, globally? You know, it's all around the world. Why all these things happen? Because they what? They're getting ready to what? Bring forth this what? New society, this digital society. You know what I'm saying? Hey, man, we seeing that we're here. You know what I'm saying? We read upon what? A great economic collapse. Also, we read upon what? All hell breaking loose. And also, things can go nuclear at any given time. So, hey, man, we seeing, hey, man, you best be on high alert. Well, with who? With Yahweh Ba'ashem Yahweh Shai. So, hey, man, you got to be watching. You got to be praying. You got to be what? Circumspect. Hey, man, knowing what time that you're living in. Because, hey, man, these things are constantly picking up every day. You seeing that what happened right there on the U.S. and Mexican border. A lot of these things ain't even been brought out because we already know that they control the media. You know, they control what? Social media. You know, all these things to rock you back to sleep. So a lot of people are watching the football game, getting ready for the playoff, getting ready for the holiday. You know what I'm saying? This bread and circus. Show constantly making keeping you up docile, unaware, and all that. By all of a sudden, you know what I'm saying? All hell will break loose, you know, in thy security while you're relaxing, while you're eating good, you know what I'm saying? While you are constantly, you know, I'm going to work today, I'm doing not even thinking of what's getting ready to happen. It's gonna happen all of a sudden. That's why, you know, the Lord gonna catch a lot of people with their britches down. You know what I'm saying? The Lord said, I would come like a thief in the night. So, one thing about it, hey. These things gonna happen all of a sudden on a normal day. It can be sunshine. All of a sudden, you can see troops are just dropping in anywhere. You know what I'm saying? Just dropping in everywhere. You know, you see bombs explode. You can see people dying everywhere all of a sudden. What's happening? What's going on? Because one thing about it, hey, you don't believe. You know what I'm saying? You still are sleeping. And out about, hey, man, it's gonna catch you in a snap, in a snare. And out about, and you will be totally destroyed. So the title of today's lesson, once again, is Chaos by Design. I have a quick precept. And after the precept, we will start the videos, and I hope that you will get edified. Let's go to get a quick precept. Start here at Jeremiah, in the book of Jeremiah, chapter 51. And I start at verse 45. It said, my people, go ye out of the midst of her, and deliver ye every man his soul from the fierce anger of the Lord. And out of the midst of what? Babylon the Great, America. And about come out of that mindset and come back under what? That total subjection to your true power, which in fact is Yahweh, by Hashem Yahweh Shai. He's the only way and he is the only answer. And also we know that our salvation and our deliverance is very close at hand. We cannot wait. Verse 45, it said, and lest your heart faint and ye fear for the rumor that shall be heard in the land. A rumor shall both come of 1 year, and after that in another year shall come a rumor and violence in the land, rulers against rulers. So that's getting ready to happen, you know, all sorts of chaos, disorder, you know, sedition among men. You know what I'm saying? We're seeing all these things kind of have rumors of what's happening on the what on the southern border, rumors of what terrorist attack, rumors of what cyber attack, all sorts of things on and on. It's constantly happening. You know what I'm saying? Also, you know, fire, explosion, you know, train derailment, and so much things are going on, you know, and also people are what are dropping unalive in a great number. You know what I'm saying? What the spirit of vengeance is in the land. You know what I'm saying? The love of many is waxing cold. You know what I'm saying? We're living in an evil time, a perilous time. Pray without ceasing. So now I start back up at verse 47. And it reads that, therefore, behold, the days come that I will do judgment upon the graven image of Babylon, and her whole land shall be confounded, and all her slain shall fall in the midst of her. So one thing about it, so this place is getting ready to be totally destroyed. We already seen what's going on in the southern, but this place has been, compromised within. You know what I'm saying? Out of body, we already know that America will be, invaded. America will be totally destroyed. And one thing about it, hey, man, wisdom and knowledge shall be the stability of time. You will have a stable mind when these things come upon us. And the only way out of here is what? It's up. If you're not getting beamed up, you're getting burnt up. So now, let's go to the video. Let's start the videos. And after the video, we'll start the lesson. And once again, I hope that you will get edified.
Hey, America. Did you know 10 IEDs were found along the Mexico-U.S. border? According to this article by Fox News, a Tucson area Border Patrol agent happened to witness a gunfight on the other side of the border at a border crossing. A couple Mexican cops responded, arrested a couple cartel guys, and what do you know, they found 10 IEDs. In the same incident, a U.S. Border Patrol agent arrested a man on this side of the border. That guy had an AK with two loaded mags and a pistol on him. Now, unfortunately, the article doesn't state what nationality the guy was that got arrested here in the United States. I personally find it a little weird. A couple gunfights break out along the border between the cartel and somebody else that has an AK with a couple loaded mags. IEDs are somehow involved, 10 of them, nonetheless. And yesterday, over in Europe, a couple terrorist cells ended up getting arrested for plotting attacks on the people of Europe. One of those cells happened to be associated with H Group. Y'all stay safe, be vigilant. Peace, love, happiness, God bless. I'm out.
First on Fox Business exclusive. U.S. Customs and Border Protection are warning Border Patrol agents to be on the lookout for explosive devices after the Mexican military seized 10 IEDs at the southern border. Fox Business's Hillary Vaughn breaking the news right now from Capitol Hill. Hillary.
Good morning. Well, that's right. The Border Patrol agents are being warned to be on the lookout for these improvised explosive devices after the Mexican military seized 10 IEDs from the Mexico side of the U.S.-Mexico border. A federal law enforcement source shared with us the officer safety alert that went out to CBP agents this week, warning them to be careful and vigilant. The alert reads this, quote, agents should exercise extreme caution and should report any possible armed subjects approaching the border with possible explosive devices. This incident happened on Wednesday. Border Patrol agents basically stumbled upon a cartel turf war gunfight near the Tres Palates Ranch east of the Sasabe Port of Entry, which is in Pima County, Arizona. They arrested a person on the U.S. side of the border who was armed with a loaded AK-47 rifle, two loaded AK magazines, loose rounds, and a handgun. That person told them there were 11 armed suspects nearby. Agents heard gunfire coming from the Mexico side, pulled back to a safer area. The Mexican military responded. That's when they found the 10 explosive devices filled with black powder and shrapnel. My law enforcement source says this ranch has a gap in the border fence that is typically used in the past to funnel drugs through, but now it's a magnet for the cartel to push people through. So this gunfight was essentially a gang war trying to fight for control over this gap in the fence. My source says this gap was just a spot in the border wall that was never completed. And it also goes to show just how increasingly dangerous it is for our law enforcement agents on the border, but also how lucrative human smuggling is for the cartel, that they're willing to have these gunfights over small gaps in the fence to try to gain control and use that as a way to push their people through, their paying customers through.
So we see that we having more what? More increase events like this happening every day. It's constantly what? Picking up more confusion, more what? Disorder. You know what I'm saying? More what? Uncertainty. You know, and great fears is getting ready to fall upon a lot of people any given day. You know what I'm saying? Hey, man, the it can hit the fan. So we'll start today's lesson in the book of 2 Ezra chapter, a very quick lesson through the Spirit. Let's start off in 2 Ezra chapter 16, very quick lesson through the Spirit. 2 Ezra chapter 16, and we'll start up at verse 18. 2 Ezra chapter 16 and verse 18. And it reads at the beginning of sorrows and great mourning, the beginning of famine and great death, the beginning of wars, and the power shall stand in fear, the beginning of evils. What shall I do when these evils shall come? One thing about these evils are constantly what? Approaching, you know, on every side. We already know we at the beginning of what? Great sorrow, the birth pain, you know, that transition of power. Also the beginning what? Of famine and great death. You know what I'm saying? It already telling you about what this cyber attack, telling you about what? Rolling blackout, power grid out, no internet, no water, no food, starvation go to set in a big way. Your necessity, your way of life is getting ready to change. And also we already knowing that, hey man, we're coming upon what? Great persecution and what? Tribulation. And it says also in the beginning of war. So we had to what? The beginning of what? World War III. We seeing it happening right before our eyes at any given time. You know, China, Russia, you know what I'm saying, in collaboration with the EU, NATO could come in here, you know what I'm saying, these sleeper cells and cause all sorts of what? Chaos. We already knowing that this place is getting ready to be totally destroyed with 200 what? Warheads, what? Them IBCM missiles, the indignation of Yahweh Ba'ashim Yahushua. And also it says, what shall I do when these evils shall come? And one thing about it is that, hey, man, if the Lord is not on your side, you're not going to be able to do anything. You know what I'm saying? You're getting ready to what? To be unalive. Hey, man, we constantly warn you. Verse 19. And it reads, said, behold, famine, plagues, tribulation, and anguish are sent as scourges for amendment. So we're seeing that, you know, the Lord is what? Is visiting the earth that he created. We're seeing that he bringing forth famine. He bringing are forced all kind of plagues, and they're not slacking down for a moment. Tribulation is constantly increased. You know what I'm saying? These scourges are constantly what are picking up. We're seeing that we're at the boiling point. You know, after what the hair trigger. You know, of things are constantly what escalating. We're seeing this every day. You know, so hey, man, we coming upon some perilous times, some dangerous times, some dark time, a time of trouble that we've never seen before. So these things are sent for scourges for a men, what a men your way and come back to your true power, which in fact is Yahweh. Hashem, Yahweh Shai. Verse 20 said, but for all these things, they shall not turn from their wickedness, nor be always mindful of the scourge. So a lot of people are not mindful. They're not considering, you know what I'm saying? They're very right now, you know, unaware, you know, they are in the congregation of the dead, and they're getting ready to be physically dead very soon. So we're seeing that these things are coming. The 2 points therein shall be cut off and die because what they are not mindful. You know what I'm saying? My people are destroyed all day long for what? A lack of knowledge. Also, they rejecting what? Their true power. Now, the Lord is going to reject them. So the Lord's getting ready what to purge out the rebel because what? They're not considering. They don't know who they are. They don't know who their true power. And also, they don't know what time that we're living in. And also, they don't know who the enemy is. You know what I'm saying? They ain't bed with the enemy. You know what I'm saying? One thing about it, the Lord said, you know, learn not the ways of the heathen. Like what these damn holidays, you know, which in fact is Christmas, New Year's, you know what I'm saying? And many others. You know what I'm saying? Hey, man. The Lord said, I hate your feast day. One thing about it, you know, the Lord wants you to come back accordingly, you know what I'm saying? And do the will of Yahweh, by Hashem Yahusha, the best of your ability. The Lord's getting ready to return, whether you believe it or not. So we still having a lot of games that still help people or what? They are sealed in their lot. You know what I'm saying? Hey, some people, they're not going to get it. So we're not even worried about them. Sealing of the let, we out of here. We cannot wait, man. We ready to get the hell out of this nightmare. Verse 21 said, behold, victory shall be good and cheap upon the earth, and that they shall think themselves to be in good case. And even then shall evil grow upon the earth, sword, famine, and great confusion. That sword also going to what? Judgment. You know what I'm saying? That great confusion going in what? Disorder, sedition among men, insurrection. You know what I'm saying? Civil war, civil unrest. All these things that we constantly seeing in the movies. You know, people are talking about it every day. You know what I'm saying? Leave the world behind. This new movie coming out, civil war. Also, you know, the takedown of America. All sorts of things are coming out. Prophecy, prophecy, prophecy. And also what the end is being manifest right before us. So a lot of people still think that they're good case. They're in their comfort zone. But one thing about it is getting ready to get uncomfortable. You know what I'm saying? You getting ready to be taken out of your comfort zone. You getting ready to be cast into hell very soon. You know what I'm saying? These FEMA camps, these guillotines. You know what I'm saying? Hey, man, hey, the devil is getting ready to come down with great wrath. And we constantly warn you, left and right, it is here. It is at the door. We're seeing it every day. You're seeing that southern border has been compromised. All these things have been designed and manufactured. Order out of chaos. You know, this new world order. They want what? Total control. But through the what? Spirit and power of Yahweh. By Hashem Yahusha. Remember, the Lord is in perfect control. And out of body, hey man, the Lord is running the whole show. The Lord is a master chess player. We're seeing that he's gathering the nation. We're seeing that the Lord is getting ready to bring it to a close and usher in the kingdom of heaven that dwells in righteousness. Woo! We cannot wait. So rejoice. So now, let's go here to Ephesians. Ephesians chapter 5. Ephesians chapter 5, one moment. Ephesians chapter 5 and verse, we start at verse 15. Ephesians chapter 5 and verse 15. And it reads, says, see then that ye walk circumspectly. That means, you know what I'm saying, know your surrounding, you know, 360 degrees, you know what I'm saying, knowing your environment, the people that you are dealing with. Be very watchful, vigilantly, you know what I mean? Be very watchful, you know what I'm saying? And one thing about it is that, hey, man, we're here, man. You know what I'm saying? It said, walk circumspectly, not as fool, but as wise. Verse 16, redeeming the time because the days of evil. The days are evil right now. We know we read upon what? The hour of temptation. We know that what Jacob's trouble is getting ready to kick off. And you know what I'm saying? It's getting ready to be a global event that we have never seen before. Now, redeem the time, why? And how do you do that? You know what I'm saying? By this what? This wisdom, this knowledge, this gospel. You know what I'm saying? One thing about it, you got to have this garment of righteousness on. You know what I'm saying? You got to what? Put on the whole armor of Yahweh by Hashem Yahusha. Because, you know, so you can what? Defend these what? Fiery darts that this devil is getting ready to come down with. You know what I'm saying? Hey, man. We getting ready. It's coming down to the wire, man. We're very close. We're excited. You know what I'm saying? Verse 17 said, wherefore, be ye not unwise, but understand what the will of the Lord is. You got to understand what the will of the Lord is. If you're not seeking the Lord, you're getting ready to die. And not about one thing about it, if you're not part of the elect, you're getting ready to die. And one thing about it, if you're a two-thirds, you already know you out of here. You just say, hey, man, one thing about it, it's plain and simple. Now examine yourself, you know, pray, you know what I'm saying? Ask the Lord to have mercy upon you, you know what I'm saying? Walk in the path of righteousness. Lean not on your own understanding, you know, confess or acknowledge, you know, that the Lord is your true power, you know? And also you got to know the true names of the Heavenly Father. The Lord's name shall be a strong tower in a time of trouble, you know, and the righteous run into it and is safe. Wisdom and knowledge shall be the stability of the time. And also Yahweh Bashem, Yahweh Shai. You don't say, hey, man, you got to know that name. It's power in that name because, hey, man, we coming upon this time. We saying that these days are constantly what? We're getting closer and closer to all hell breaking loose. You know what I'm saying? Chaos by design, you know, it's getting worse and worse. You know, it's all sorts of events around the world, left and right, constantly increasing. So, hey, man, we're seeing it happening. You know what I'm saying? Violence is increasing. Wickedness has increased. And the Lord is getting ready to what to destroy this place. The Lord's eyes is upon what the sinful kingdom. What is that sinful kingdom? Babylon the Great, a.k.a. America. Hey, man, this place is getting ready to go down, man. We constantly warn you. So now let's go to our last and final script. We'll close out here. Second Ezra chapter 8. Just a quick lesson through the Spirit. Second Ezra chapter 8 and verse 50. We'll close out here. Second Ezra chapter 8 and verse 50. And it reads, for many great miseries shall be done to them that in the latter time shall dwell in the world because they have walked in great pride. So one thing about it, so America, you know, is the most proud, you know, do thy will spirit. A lot of people, you know what I'm saying, are self-will, you know, are very covetous, you know what I'm saying? All sorts of people that hate the truth, you know what I'm saying? Truth breakers, you know, all sorts of sexual immorality, you know what I'm saying? All sorts of wickedness, you know what I'm saying? Amen. And the Lord is getting ready, you know, to come, you know what I'm saying, and settle this matter very soon. It ain't going to be no more unbelieving. It's not going to be any more people running rampant, you know what I'm saying? These women's all out of order. Everyone is all out of order except for the elect, you know what I'm saying? We trying to serve the Lord the best of our ability and hoping that the Lord blot our sins out at his coming, you know what I'm saying? Hey, man, we're very close. We're so very excited. So many great what misery, many great what calamities and what catastrophes is getting ready to come before, you know, things are happening left and right, one behind another, you know, and you're constantly what picking up. Every day you can't hardly keep up with. You can turn right now, you go to sleep tonight, wake up, it's World War III, people dropping bombs everywhere. Just like a scenario like that. Just like, hey man, these movies coming out. You know, hey man, it's in plain sight. The end is being manifest. You know, hey man, speaking at the end, you know, these prophecies are picking up. You know what I'm saying? High time to prophesy. And also it's time to seek your true power while he can be found. The door of repentance is closed. You know what I'm saying? And the Lord is getting ready to bring forth that judgment. And one thing about it is that when the Lord bring it, there will be no more talking. So the title of the day lesson, once again, is Chaos by Design. So I'd like to give all praises and honor and glory to Yahweh by Hashem, Yahweh Shai by Hashem, Rekha Kadosh. I'd like to say, Shalom, Shalom.